Croeso, and welcome back to my channel. Today we take a look at a legend from Welsh mythology, a legend of a massive boar, and one of the many legends surrounding King Arthur, the legend of Twrch Trwyth. Before we start, I want to take the chance to apologize to all Welsh speakers. I love the Welsh language, but I'm just not able to pronounce it properly. If you have any advice how to improve my pronunciation, please let me know in the comments down below. Maybe I include some bloopers at the end of the video. But for now, let's do it. Let's talk about the legend of Twrch Trwyth. Appropriately, the name Twrch Trwyth is Welsh for the boar named Trwyth. And a boar he is. A giant, malicious boar appearing in the legends of the Mabinogion. But where did this boar come from? Is he some kind of fake creature, of a morion? Was he released by an evil force to scorch the earth? Well, actually, no. Twrch Trwyth began his life as an Irish prince, the son of Prince Taled, or Taled Vledig. But how did the prince, or king, become a massive boar? Well, you might think, like in many legends, his story started out as a rivalry or love triangle, ending in a curse to cut him out of the equation. But no, he was not an innocent man cursed by an evil entity. Instead, it was him who was the evil one, and a deity who turned him into the creature we are talking about. As a cursed boar, he possessed poisonous bristles, and between his ears there were shears, a comb, and a razor. He was accompanied by 7 pigs, who were also cursed men, and together they roamed Ireland and wreaked havoc. But the story of how Twrch Trwyth was turned, and what mischiefs he and his pigs did, is actually not that interesting. The interesting part of Twrch Trwyth's life is actually part of a bigger story, the story of Culwch and Olwen. Within the Mabinogion, the story of Culwch and Olwen is a simple love story that, in a way, resembles the labors of Hercules or Heracles. The story begins with Culwch refusing his stepmother's wish to marry his stepsister. As a revenge, his stepmother cursed him to only be able to marry the daughter of the infamous giant Ispadar the Mancower, a girl named Olwen. And so, it was just a matter of time until Culwch met Olwen and actually fell in love with her. He went to Ispadar and asked for his daughter's hand. And to everyone's surprise, Ispadar agreed. But before Culwch was allowed to marry Olwen, he had to fulfill a sequence of 40 seemingly impossible tasks. I'll cover the whole story of Culwch and Olwen in another video. But for now, fast forward to the task that brings us back to Twrch Trwyth. The most difficult and probably biggest task for Culwch was the acquiring of the shears, comb, and razor from Twrch Trwyth's head. Why, you ask? Well, Ispadar demanded them so that Culwch could shave his beard for the wedding. Culwch soon was aware that he would need help to fulfill this task. And what better help could he get than the help of the legendary King Arthur, who just happened to be his cousin. So he went to Arthur and asked for help. And Arthur happily gathered his men to came to assist his cousin in the hunt for Twrch Trwyth and this monstrous cursed pigs, which, like mentioned before, caused havoc in Ireland. The hunt began in Ireland, but after a while, and the death of one of the pigs caused by Arthur, Twrch Trwyth and his men fled into the sea, swimming over to Wales, to Porth Clyse near St. David's Head in Pembrokeshire, where they also caused a lot of havoc, and where the biggest part of the hunt took place. Culwch, Arthur and his men didn't give up though. They chased the boars to Wales and landed somewhere near Milford Haven, where the hunt began anew. And a hunt it was, all over Wales, from Pembrokeshire to Carmarthenshire, to Ceredigion, to Swansea Valley, to the Valley of Awas, and in the end, to Cornwall. I probably forgot a few, if not a lot of places in between, but it's actually quite a long list, and I cover that in detail in another video. However, on the way, Twrch Trwyth's pigs and Arthur's men fought battle for battle, and the pigs managed to kill a lot of Arthur's men, but in the end were slain themselves. All but Twrch Trwyth himself. But even Twrch Trwyth couldn't fight King Arthur and his men forever. In the end, he was confronted by King Arthur, and an epic battle on top of a cliff arose. Arthur wasn't able to kill Twrch Trwyth, but the giant boar ended up falling off the cliff, vanishing into the Irish Sea, never to be seen again. But not before the warriors were able to acquire the requested items. Rumor has it that Twrch Trwyth drowned there and then, but maybe he was able to save himself back to Ireland and to live a little bit more cautious and quiet for the rest of his days. Who knows? Well, that was a short version of Twrch Trwyth's role in the Mabinogion. A wild and evil, but also fearless boar, and leader of a horde of other magical boars, fighting against King Arthur and his men, just to meet the demands of a malicious giant. Well, since he started out as an Irish prince, causing havoc in Ireland, it's not really a big wonder that he has an equivalent in Ireland. In Ireland, there's a magical boar known as Twrch Trwyth. Sometimes he's described as a different version of Twrch Trwyth, but actually, Twrch Trwyth started out as the half-brother of the legendary Diarmuid O'Donn, from the story of Diarmuid and Grainne, killed by the hand of Diarmuid's father and brought back to life as a boar by his own father. Seemingly just to spite Diarmuid's father, who knew that it was prophesied that Diarmuid would die at the hand of a boar one day. And in the end, it was actually Twrch Trwyth who killed Diarmuid. There are still a few places in Ireland that give us a clue of the significance of the wild boar in Irish folklore, like the Ross Muck in the west of the province Connacht, in which muck means pig, or the place Cantorc, deriving from the Irish Cian Torca, meaning the boar's head, in the west of County Cork, and a few more. For there are more boars in Irish folklore than just Twrch Trwyth. But that's a story for another day. Apart from these places in Ireland, there are a lot of places in Wales referring to Twrch Trwyth. The story is so popular that you can actually follow the tracks of the hunt throughout Wales. And you find that he also found his way into the arts. For you find sculptures of Twrch Trwyth, for example, in St. David's, Trenethy, St. Clair's, or one in Pennybank in Emmonford. And if you now want to encounter Twrch Trwyth yourself, in a video game of course, you can take a look at Fate Grand Order, or at Clan O'Connell and the Crown of the Stag, where he chases you mercilessly, and is probably the only character in the game you don't actually fight. But he's challenging either way, believe me. But I think that's it for today's video. By the way, what is your favorite creature from Celtic mythology? Let me know in the comments down below. Oh, and if you want to see my struggles with the Welsh language, stick around until the end of the video. See you next time. Bye! Tarit, or Tarit, Tarit, Welic? Tarit, Welic? Twrch Trwyth began his life as an Irish prince, the son of Prince Tarit, or Tarit, and a hunt it was, all over Wales, from Pembrokeshire to Carmarthenshire. The different... And a hunt it was, all over Wales, from Pembrokeshire to Carmarthenshire. The different... And minith... And a hunt it was, all over Wales, from Pembrokeshire to Carmarthenshire, the different Chrushur and Minith Amanu, and different Amanu, to Cedigran the Chrushur. Can't be that hard.